We're imagining creatively with Luca at Palazzo Mora at the Biennale in Venice. And Luca is one of the very few young Venetians that choose to stay in the city because he has a passion for the art history. So Luca, what's your vision for this city and how can the history of Venice and the amazing heritage here contribute to imagining more creatively peaceful coexistence?
Look, about Venice, in Venice this time it's so difficult to live because always in the touristic economic is so strong here. And so we are full of tourists, full of not beautiful tourism because the massive are moving here and it's not so good for the city. So it's not so good. It's always good when the people come here and to visit. But I'd like to Venice, to the people, I'd like that the people like come here, will come here to enjoy the heritage, like you see about the city and what's the art of the city and like to enjoy the palaces too. And like this foundation, but European Cultural Center, they are doing a really good job because it's like moving the using of the palaces to tourists, to art. And art can be a really, really good vehicle for the people here to enjoy Venice more. Because everyone knows about Venice about like a museum in the world, like a museum, like a city museum. But it's not true because people live here and people have to know the city more.
Go to the roots and see the art. Zoom out a little bit. There's amazing exhibits everywhere. So what can you imagine creatively about making these art places interesting for people and draw the millions of tourists that come here every year to connect a little bit to the depth and the beauty of the past? That has lessons for the future.
This is beautiful. This is this way of to see the city between more contemporary, because Venice is contemporary too. It's not like the city that you imagine of the 16th century, 17th century. Even Venice is alive. It has contemporary art. It has beautiful structure. It has this structure in this amazing palace and this mixture about the culture. Venice has always been a mixture of culture between the years, between the cycles. And so it's beautiful that it's still like this thinking about the mixture of culture, the mixture. Here in this exhibition there are like 130 authors from all over the world. And it's like the being the soul of Venice, this one, I imagine, because Venice always, like I said before, it's always been a city that's traded with all the people in all over the world, and it's like the way that Venice has to grow up, not like with the massive tourism. I work with the tourism, but I like to have tourists that are can enjoy the city, not only go to San Marco and see the square and go back. Just enjoy these passes and this way to this other places of Venice, the littlest places of Venice, that are the most beautiful one.
So good luck, and we want to stay connected with how you're going to imagine strategies of moving millions of tourists to the next level, starting with a few, moving to the next level of depth and connection to the history and the art, and the fact that this was an amazing model of peaceful coexistence that created art exchange and cooperation with so many other peoples.
So many other peoples and so many other artists probably, and it's like probably to improve to be more palace starting to do like this, it would be great, and not to become an hotels in Venice. Yes, yes.
So if people come to Venice, you want them to scratch a little bit the surface and go.
Yeah,
underneath.
I'd like to the people that come to Venice respect the city and try to see not only San Marco and Rialto, but try to go inside the heritage of Venice because it's the most beautiful one, and just like And if you understand the heritage, you will understand better the sea, and you will love more the city. Sorry, not the sea, the city. Sorry about the English.
Thank you, Luca. Amazing. Okay. And good luck with your work. We want to know all about it, because okay. There is room to imagine creatively more.
Okay.